Blackstone Audio presents
Against All Hope by Armando Valladares. Translated by Andrew Hurley. Dedication. To the memory of my companions, tortured and murdered in Fidel Castro's jails, and to the thousands of prisoners still suffering in them, who against hope believed in hope. From Romans chapter 4, verse 18. Man is nature's most wonderful creature. Torturing him, crushing him, murdering him for his beliefs and ideas is more than a violation of human rights. It is a crime against all humanity. Armando Valladares. Introduction. This book is my personal account of the 22 years I spent in the political prisons of Cuba, solely for having espoused and expressed principles distinct from those of the regime of Fidel Castro. In my country, there is a fact which not even the most fervent defenders of the Cuban Revolution can deny. A dictatorship has existed there for more than a quarter of a century. And no dictatorship can remain in power for so long without violating human rights, without persecutions, without political prisoners, without political prisons. In Cuba, at this very moment, there are more than 200 penal installations, ranging from maximum security prisons to concentration camps to so-called farms and open fronts, where prisoners do forced labor. In every one of these 200 or so prisons, there is material for dozens of books, which means that these pages are the merest sketch of the terrible reality of Cuban prisons. Someday, when the history of all of them is known in detail, mankind will feel the revulsion it felt when the crimes of Stalin were brought to light. In its latest reports, Amnesty International has denounced the executions of dozens of political opponents of the regime, the physical mistreatment and abuse, the beatings. And when it appealed to the Cuban government to abolish the death penalty, the vice president of Cuba, Carlos Rafael Rodriguez, who had been a minister in the Batista government as well, answered that the death penalty was necessary in Cuba. Rodriguez was also quoted in an interview published in Madrid's Diario 26 on October 10, 1983, as saying, in answer to the interviewer's question whether groups struggling for labor union freedom and for human rights existed in Cuba, that indeed people holding such idyllic ideas as the freedom to organize into labor unions and the protection of human rights did exist, but that he predicted a future of ridicule for them. For me, this book represents the long night I have left behind me, but for the thousands of my countrymen still held in the jails, for my comrades, some of whom have already spent 25 years in prison, it represents daily reality. They have been held longer than any other political prisoners in Latin America, perhaps in the world. The violence, repression, and beatings, the torture, the lack of mail, news, and visits, and the solitary confinement are facts of life for them. Today, at this very moment, hundreds of political prisoners are naked, sleeping on the floors of cells whose windows and doors have been sealed. They never see the light of day, or for that matter, artificial light. They are denied medical care and visits, and all because they refused to enter the political rehabilitation program. Photographs of some of the people I talk about in this book are included here, as evidence that those people really existed, really exist, that they are people with faces. Those who are still alive reside now in the United States, Venezuela, and other countries. I feel I should say that in my terrible pilgrimage from prison to prison, I did meet military men and women and civilian officials of great humaneness, men and women who helped as much as they could, and in so doing risked going to prison themselves. In order to protect them, their names and the favors they did us cannot be revealed. I do not want to conclude without recalling those to whom I owe my freedom and reiterating my gratitude to them. Their names are not written here because the list would grow much too long for a brief introduction, and also because there are people whose names I do not even know, people whose thoughts were with me, who anonymously worked to free me, help me, who did things for me I perhaps am not even aware of. To all of these I send, with this book, my best, the best from my memory, the best from my heart. Armando Valladares, Madrid, 1984. Chapter 1. Detention. My eyes flew open. The cold muzzle of a machine gun held to my temple had shocked me awake. I was confused and frightened. Three armed men were standing around my bed, and one of them was shoving my head into the pillow with his machine gun. "Where's the pistol?" As the man with the machine gun kept my head immobile, another slid his hand under it to check for that purely imaginary pistol I was supposed to be armed with. Then the oldest of them, a thin man with graying hair, spoke to me again. He brusquely told me to get dressed. I had to go with them. These were agents of Castro's political police. I was to learn later that the older man, the one doing the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.